wingless. Welcome.
Thank you for having me. It's amazing. I'm only here for a day, but I've heard lots. I love you too!
So Alfie, first time in Puerto Rico?
First time in Puerto Rico. I'm loving it. It's great.
Great.
I'm definitely going to come back here for a holiday. I've got the beach right beside me, so I'm a happy man.
Oh yeah, you definitely have to come back with more time and enjoy the city,
the
island. It's got beautiful beaches and a lot of places to go. Yeah. And of course, beautiful women, of course, right?
Of course, come on.
I don't know if you have time
to look
around.
You're the Wonder Woman right here. Come on, please.
All right. So English actor.
English actor, that's me. English actor, Alfie Allen. Hello.
Alfie. You know, it requires a lot of training and physical preparation for the role that you play in Game of Thrones.
Yeah.
How has your fitness and diet routine changed in order for you to have the strength and stamina?
Well, when I first started it, I changed my whole body shape for the show. HBO got us into the gym pretty quickly.
How much training did it require?
A lot of training.
A few months before?
I was four months in training.
Cool. How many times a week?
Three times a week.
Okay.
Sometimes four. Usually, towards the end of it, I kind of go every day.
Right.
But my fitness was very, very good back then. I've relaxed a little bit in recent years.
Yeah, I guess you do have to have those.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Exactly. You've got to have a little respite from time to time. Do you know what I mean? But no, it was great just to be able to sort of get in shape. And Kit was already in shape with his six pack, so I had to catch up with Kit and Richard.
And learn some martial arts.
Not really, no. I didn't really learn martial arts. I did a lot of sort of training with the bow and arrow.
But definitely with the bow and horseback riding. Did you know?
I did lots of horseback riding. Lots of horseback riding. Lots of bow and arrow training. Not so much sword fighting, but you know, I had some kind of sexy scenes in it, so I wanted to look good.
Woohoo! Can we see that six pack though?
It's not there anymore.
It's not there anymore? Okay. Sorry, yo trate, I tried.
I've got one in the fridge. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Keeping them cold.
Indeed.
So that's the physical preparation that requires, but mentally, psychologically, it's very difficult for you to live like the torture scenes, particularly.
Yeah, yeah.
And how challenging is it for you to recreate a pain which you've never experienced before, right?
Yeah, I mean, to be honest with you, it's something that, unless I want to go out and stick a nail through my foot, which I don't want to do, it's hard to gauge something like that.
Right.
You know, how much pain is, and how much, what is my own pain threshold? It's not something that...
For instance, the director tell you, no, we need a more painful face.
Yeah, I mean, you get directors who need more, but at the end of the day, HBO give you so much freedom as an actor that kind of what you do, it kind of goes most of the time, and they're just like, yeah, that's fine, that's great, and if they need you to up the ante, they will, but in terms of pain and gauging that was difficult, but I looked a lot into sort of Stockholm syndrome. I researched that because there's definitely a bit of that between Ramsay and Theon, where it's a
what love. What is the Stockholm syndrome?
Reek. Between Ramsay, it's Reek. You're right. There was some research I did into that because there's kind of a love hate relationship going on there
with the Stockholm syndrome.
Yes.
Interesting, never heard of that before.
What, Stockholm Syndrome?
No.
It's when your captor falls in love with the with your captive.
Oh!
Yeah.
Okay.
So there was definitely some of that going on there without
a doubt. How do you grab confidence? How do you have that confidence for those fighting scenes and to play the character that you play?
It comes naturally.
Naturally, of course!
obviously, you know, the character Theon Greyjoy is confident to begin with, and then the kind of arc of the character definitely goes a different way, and he's humbled, you know? When you lose that part of your body, I think anyone's going to be slightly humbled.
They all want to know, right?
Huh?
They want to, for some reason.
They like him. They like
it's
him.
A classic question.
It's a, exactly.
So, what would you say would be the most challenging part about bringing this script to life, your character to life?
Like? I would say the arc was definitely the most challenging part because, in a way, in the show, he's one of the more human characters. He makes mistakes, which is a universal theme. Everyone can relate to that. Everyone kind of wants to see themselves as a hero, without a doubt, but to sort of, I guess, have empathy for a character that is less than all the time was tough. But at the same time, it was a real great challenge for me. And there were times where I didn't feel I really did have as much empathy as I needed to for the character. But that's probably just me beating myself up. But
are there any characteristics with the character that you play that you would identify yourself with, that you'd say you guys are similar or perhaps different?
Confidence.
Yeah. That we know.
I would say, he started off well down there, so I have that in common. No, not really, to be honest. No. Situational-wise, maybe, but in terms of personality, definitely not.
Okay. So, how many of the books have you read?
How many? I've read the first 2.5.
And there are a lot of them. There are around 7 or more.
There's 7 of them, yeah. I didn't want to preempt stuff later on, so I didn't want to sort of see a scene or see something in the books that I really liked.
Yeah.
And then prepare myself for it, and then it come out completely different when the writer, because they're two different things. The show and the books have taken on lives of their own now, do you know what I mean? The books are completely different to the show almost. It's a completely different medium. And so I would say, I didn't want to preempt stuff. And also, my character wasn't really mentioned that much in the third book, so I kind of lost interest.
Then he came back, I don't need to read anymore. How about George Martin? How about working with him?
The Beatles producer?
He is actually...
the writer of the
books.
Writer,
yeah. The writer. Yeah. But he sometimes is part of the series. He works...
George Martin.
Does he work with the...
George Martin.
Yes. The writer.
He does...
I'm working with him.
Good. He comes on set... from time to time, not so much anymore, but when he does, it's definitely an event, and we're waiting for him with bated breath, because he still writes, I think, one of the episodes every year, and so he's just a really nice guy. He's kind of a very charitable fellow in real life. I mean, in real life, he's always in real life, but he's just a lovely guy.
An approachable
dude.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So the series has been filmed in so many locations, including Croatia, Iceland, Malta, Morocco, Spain, USA.
USA? It has gone to USA.
How do you adapt to filming in so many different locations? And what has been your favorite place to film?
Well, I've only filmed in Belfast. So I would say Belfast is great.
Yes. That would be your first choice.
Belfast is good. It has good restaurants, a very good student nightlife, and there's just so many talented people that come out of that country for it being so small and the population not being that massive. A lot of talent, literary talent, comes out of there. But in terms of adapting to, I mean, for Theon, Reek, winter is coming is so true in so many respects because, you know, it's just always cold, dirty, and horrible.
Cold and harsh.
Yeah.
2 seasons are coming up.
Yeah.
Game of Thrones.
Woo!
Yes. 7th and 8th season, program for 2017 and 2018. What can we expect as fans?
What can you expect?
Yeah.
Just more of the same,
more torture.
But better.
More torture.
More torture, more dragons. More dragons, more... no dragons! You don't want dragons! You want dragons, right? Yeah, loads of dragons! So let dragons, torture, because Trini wants to see some torture.
Definitely, we love those torture scenes.
Trini loves torture, I love this. Wonder Woman, I never took you one who likes torture.
Okay, but this conversation we have to have it off stage. Yeah.
We're getting along just fine.
He definitely has a lot of confidence.
Hey.
Okay. So, it's been fun. I want to give the public a chance to get to know you a little bit more.
Definitely.
So you guys ready for some questions? See?
Let's do it.
All right. ¿Hay algún micrófono ya en piso? ¿Sí?
Who wants to ask? Who wants to ask questions? No one.
Oh, they're all okay, so shy.
Come on then. What do you want?
Mira, ahí va Alfie. Hello?
I wanted to ask you what has been your favorite episode of film and why?
What's been my favorite episode to film and why? Probably at the end of the second series, there was the bit where I kind of do my big speech, and then I get hit on the back of the head. That was probably that was probably my favorite bit, because it was just it didn't require much, I guess, acting on my front. I just kind of went for it, and it was great, and it was all about me. Thank you.
We got another question coming up here.
Okay, cool. All right. Oh, hello. Danny!
Yeah.
Woohoo!
Well, I got a question for you. Do you think Theon Greyjoy is able or possesses the right amount of qualities to be a king and to rule the Seven Kingdoms? And if you think so, why?
I would say, I've got to be honest, no. I don't think he does possess the qualities. For one, he can't reproduce an heir. But then at the same time, that would be good, because then he gets to choose who is, you know, I think he's been humbled so much now as a man that he's quite wise to the ways of the world and the way it works, especially in the game of Game of Thrones, in the world of Game of Thrones, that he now can choose his own heir. Otherwise, we'd end up with someone like Donald Trump!
Also, can I take a really quick picture with you?
Yeah, definitely. Way boo!
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Way boo, Danny!
Muchas gracias.
Yay, Danny!
Woo! So, Alfie, pick someone from the public.
Okay, yeah. Someone from the public.
Random.
Do you want to do it? Or
random,
I?
It's your choice. I'll Are we Facebook Live by any chance? Yeah, cool.
I wanted to ask you, how was it playing the part with Ramsay Bolton? You know, the church scenes and everything?
Yeah.
How do you know handle that? And how was it like filming those parts with
him? It was good. First of all, me and Uan, we made sure that we were friends and that we got along, because it would be pretty difficult shooting those scenes if we weren't. And we didn't really prepare for them. I mean, we'd rehearsed from time to time, but if we did something that we really enjoyed and we really liked, we would talk about it, but rarely would we talk about it afterwards. But most of the time, we just go out and play pool and drink.
I have someone at the back. Vamos uno y uno, uno y uno. Dame mismo, ya mismo. All right, who do we have?
Hi.
Thanks, babe.
Hello.
Hello.
So my question is...
Jorge.
Huh?
Is your name Jorge?
No. Jose.
Yeah. Thank you.
Hi. My question is, as an actor, how difficult was it to portray the change from Theon, from very strong character and very confident, to the breakdown he had during the series?
I'll be honest, you know, it's a collaborative effort. The writers make my job a hell of a lot easier. But yeah, it was just many things, like my voice. I kind of tried to change the voice of the character, the body posture of him, his body language, and just to always be overly aware of his surroundings is something that I try to work in, and just to be quite skittish and just to be full of fear, basically, and then that can kind of, I guess, evolve into rage, which you might see, who knows?
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Gracias, Jose. ¿A quién tenemos por acá? La colorada, vamos a ver.
Hello.
Hello. Okay, when you audition for this part, do you expect the series to be like this great? Like,
I didn't. When I auditioned for the part, I was watching The Wire. And so I already knew HBO were definitely some people that I wanted to work with. And then later on in the auditions, I started researching the books, and then I realized how much of a huge following the books has. So I knew about the writers, David and Dan. I knew they were very talented, and I knew the content was going to be good because of that, and also the books. But I didn't envisage the following that it has. I knew it was going to be big in America, but I didn't know it was going to be so big worldwide. And so that was amazing, and it still is amazing. But at the same time, the content's always been good. So it just gets better and better, really. So I know I'm in good hands.
Okay, can I take a picture with you?
Yeah,
if you want. Okay. Come on.
Hello.
My question is, do you guys ever pull pranks on each other on the set? Any good ones?
Yes, we do. I do this one quite a lot.
All right.
Sorry.
It's okay, we got time.
Okay, look, this is my lunch. Oh no, there's kids here. I can't do that. There's kids here. I can't do that. But we do that a lot. We show each other texts and stuff. Hello.
So, what's your favorite, thing about your character? And if you were an actor, what would you be?
If I wasn't an actor, what would I be? I'd be a snowboarder. And then if my favorite trait about my character is probably he's a human being. You know, he's like, he makes mistakes. That's probably what I like about him most, is that he's not this archetypal hero. He's complicated and he's different. And so I guess I couldn't sort of narrow down one thing for you that I like, but as a whole, he's just a complicated character. And I relate to that.
Okay. So Alfie, Giselle has a question. When you're not filming, she wants to know, how do your days go by when you're not filming?
Are you filming me? My days go by when I'm not filming. I might go to the cinema on my own. I eat a lot.
What's your favorite food?
What's my favorite food? I like fish. I like fish a lot.
Clean food.
Plain food?
Like clean
food.
Clean food. Fish.
Clean food. Yeah. Clean food.
Soul food.
Hi, Mom.
and lastly, can I give you a hug?
Yeah.
Of course.
Take care.
All right. So we have another girl here. Hi.
Hi, I'm such a big fan.
Hello, babe. How are you?
My question is, if you were given the chance to play any other character in the show, who would it be and why?
I'll be honest with you, and I know you lot probably not going to believe me, but it is true, Ramsay.
Woo! They like that.
Yeah, of course.
¿Qué más? Okay. ¿Qué pregunta tiene? ¿Cuál es tu nombre? Ariel. Go for it.
Alfie. Hold on. Who's that? Oh, there
you are. Here.
Hello. Well, how do you feel this show has elevated your career? How do you see it has been affected?
I mean, I'll be honest with you. I try and live in the present an awful lot. I don't really see my career as like a point of trajectory of like where it's gonna go or what it's gonna be. I just try and enjoy it and enjoy myself. I think anyone should try and do that with anything. Don't ever take yourself too seriously. And so I don't really. I don't know, I don't really try and plan out my career, I just sort of trust my instinct. But in terms of it being great for my career so far, it has, it's been amazing. So I've been able to be in rooms that I haven't been in before, that I wouldn't have been able to get in. You know, great directors are emailing me, and it's great. You know, it's just when you're in a TV show and you're signed in for 7 years, it limits you to other things that you can do. So in terms of where it's going to take me, who knows?
Would you like to go back to Broadway?
Would I like to go? I've never been on Broadway.
You not in the beginning?
No.
No? Okay.
I'm from London, babe.
Can we say that was a blooper?
can we take a selfie though?
Yeah, go ahead.
I got a thumb, Broadway.
Okay, ¿quién más? Ay, Dios mío, me da una pena. Yo quiero cogerlos a todos.
Hello, my name is Karen.
How you doing?
Topics, okay. From all the things you've been part of, which one is your favorite and which one is the least of your favorite?
I don't have a least favorite. But in terms of my favorite scene, it's probably... some of the stuff between me and Yara was great. I love some of the stuff between me and Yara. The scene on the horse was pretty good. That was funny. We had a laugh shooting that, and it was an amazing location. So in terms of a particular scene, that one was a good one.
All right.
You mean if that happens? Gotta stop looking at the internet, guys, alright? I would say he would feel... he'd feel horrible. He'd feel awful. And he'd see it as a chance to redeem himself, but... Yeah. That's all you wanted, wouldn't it? You don't care about the question.
So we have another question here. ¿Cuál es tu nombre? Lisaidi. Strike a pose. Lisaidi has a question for you.
Hello. You're right. Yes, I'm fine. Basically, my question is more towards your career and your work as an actor. I am about to start studying acting next year, so I would really like to know about your experiences as an actor. Besides Game of Thrones, I know you do films and theater as well, so yeah. I would like to know about those experiences you've actually had and what advices can you give me when it comes to that work?
I would say the same thing I just said to somebody else. Don't take yourself too seriously. Have a lot of fun doing it.
Stay grounded,
exactly. And, you know, just... in the same kind of vein, just don't do things for other people. Only do it for yourself.
And
have fun. Yeah, just don't ever think you're performing for anyone else, because you're not. You're doing it for you.
All the time. Stay real to yourself and what you do. Okay? Así que... buen consejo.
Thank you, you too.
Buen consejo. Someone else from the crowd.
Yeah.
Hi, Alfie. Okay.
Who is it? Oh.
It's me. Hi. If you could be from any house, which one would you belong to and why?
Greyjoys, man. Come on. Definitely Greyjoys, because we're the best. Oh, Greyjoys!
Okay. All right, who's next?
I just drove 2 hours to ask you this question. I'm from Boston. Okay, question. The question is, you know that obviously some of the fans of Game of Thrones will want this answer, so please, I hope you can tell us. I'm a big fan of Daenerys Targaryen and also Jon Snow. And maybe the question is, if maybe in the future they're going to have like an alien or something, they're going to like fight together against King's Landing, because I know some of us are fans of Jon Snow, some of Daenerys, and we don't want like to fight against each other, maybe to go in an alien.
or maybe they can get married, or I don't know. So can you tell us something about that?
No.
Gina has a question.
So, Bandy.
Hey, Gina.
Hi. So I'm a big defender of Theon. I was wondering if you agreed with every decision he's ever taken, like throughout the book.
Absolutely not.
Absolutely not.
Definitely not. I would say, but that's what makes him. That's what makes him a great character.
Is right, he's flawed.
He's flawed, and he makes mistakes, which is.
But he's not necessarily like a bad person.
No. You know, and that's human. That's humankind. Okay. You know what I mean? We're flawed.
Yes.
And we all want to see ourselves as heroes, but that's just not that's not real, is it?
Thank you.
Yes. Alfie.
Yes.
Oh, we're here.
Hello. What's to be expected between the alliance of Daenerys and the Greyjoys?
Jason.
Yes.
What's the expected between the alliance of Daenerys and the Greyjoys? You just gotta wait and see, dude. You gotta wait and see. I really can't give anything away. There you go.
All right.
Yo, who? Oh, come on, we gotta let her go first.
She is Cinderella!
Hey, Cinderella, baby.
Hi, pleased to meet you.
Pleased to meet you too.
Well, I don't know if this has been asked, but I'm gonna do something theater related. So, during your time in Epos starring Daniel Radcliffe, did you have a different approach to the character of Alan back then?
Well, to Daniel, you mean?
Yeah.
I mean, I don't know is the answer to that, because I don't know what Daniel's approach was, but at the same time, I think mine was probably a more visceral Alan Strang than Daniel's was, and I got to sort of do different types of performances each week because I was touring around the UK. Rather than being in one place. But to be honest with you, I don't know how different it was. I never saw Daniel do it, so I don't know.
Oh, so no shared rehearsals back then?
Well, because we didn't do it together.
Ah.
He did it another time, and then I did it after him.
Ah.
So I didn't actually meet Daniel.
So, okay. You know, I've been to London like 6 years ago, and I did see Iron Man.